Hey, it's Gordon Dean, FY Real Estate Guy, and today we're going to talk about a very important part of the home purchase process. So for your information, today we're going to talk about home inspections. We're here with Mark Baxley at Brick and Mortar Home Inspections. He's the owner-operator, and today we're going to discuss the home inspection process. So Mark, tell me why we'd even need to inspect a home, and what are you going to do to inspect it?
Well, typically as we go through the home, Gordon, we'll inspect just about 1,600 items in the home. Typically, we'll start with the roof, do the exterior coming through the garage, do the interior living spaces last. That includes pulling the panel off the cover off the electrical panel, examining all the wiring underneath the panel, and then also checking all the outs within the home. We inspect and test all the appliances as well as the gas-fired mechanical equipment. Very thorough inspection, and we recommend everyone in a real estate transaction to have their home inspected.
Okay, so you're going to go through roof, ceiling, walls, plumbing,
correct.
Check appliances, fire things up. Man, you know, I got to be home by 8 tonight, so how long is this whole thing going to take?
Yeah, well, typically, you know, a lot depends on the age and the square footage of the home, but a typical home inspection will run about 2.5 hours.
Okay, great, cool. Well, so why would I even use a home inspector? Because like my uncle Ed out in Iowa built a garage once, and he's going to come out and inspect the house for free. Or like your buddy next door who helped you put the picnic table together, he can inspect it for free. Why would I use you
sure.
over someone who sure. knows houses?
Sure. Well, we belong to the American Society of Home Inspectors, and we're certified inspectors.
Now, is that a fraternal organization, or how do you get into that?
No, it's a professional organization
okay.
to which we belong. To be a certified inspector, you have to have completed at least 250 inspections, pass the national exam, and then you submit a body of your work to a panel, and they review the inspection reports that we have completed, and they certify us.
So not everybody with a ladder and a flashlight is going to get in?
That's correct.
Okay, great. There's a lot of things that go into being a home inspector, and Mark's going to tell us about brick and mortar.
Yep. Well, Gordon, thank you. Brick and mortar home inspections, like Gordon said, we've been in business for about 14, almost 15 years now. Completed over 11,000 inspections, so there's not a whole lot out there that we haven't seen. Okay. But some of the most unique features, I think, of our company is we offer several warranty items that we put in place to help the home buyer.
Hang on a minute. You're going to warranty something just because you looked at it?
Well, we stand behind the work that we do.
Gotcha. Yeah. So you're providing that level of protection to the buyer.
Correct.
Because you stand behind what you do.
We do. And one of the basic fundamental premises of our business is we truly feel we have a duty to help others. And by offering these additional warranty programs, that's exactly what we're doing. We give a fantastic inspection, but we also back up our work with warranties.
There you have the basics of home inspections. To get a hold of Mark Baxley of Brick and Mortar, I'll provide his contact info below. To get a hold of me, just make a comment and I'll respond to your comments. Better yet, like, share, and subscribe so you don't miss anything more from Gordon Dean, the FYI Real Estate Guy.